Before we start this off, just want to wish everyone a very Merry Christmas. Feliz Navidad to all. But look, despite it being a holiday, I hope everyone is enjoying it. We got business at hand this Sunday. It is Dallas week. It is Birds versus the Boys this upcoming Sunday down in Big D. And today we are going to preview this game because, listen, I know some Eagles fans are not looking forward to this game, but it is Dallas week, so get up. Let's get this started. It is your boy, El Parcero, affiliate of all things sports and culture here in the beautiful city of Philadelphia. Before we move forward, ladies and gentlemen, please do not forget to hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, hit that bell button for notifications, as well as sharing this video and this channel to help your favorite Parcero grow here in this beautiful city of Philadelphia. But that is right, guys. It is Dallas. It is Philly. Listen, if you are a diehard fan, you know what this freaking rivalry means to you. Get up for Dallas week because we hate Dallas, and Dallas, you suck. That is right. And this is a crazy-ass time for Dallas and Philly because the division that we're in right now is absolutely god-awful. And to think that the first-place team might have 6 wins heading into the playoffs representing our division, it is what it is. It truly is what it is. But we got to take care of business. And at the end of the day, as an Eagles fan, I want my Birds in the playoffs. And I know you guys do want it too. I know the whole draft pick conversation. Should we tank for that draft pick or should we go out here and win? And listen, the Eagles, the players, that locker room, they're not going to sit down here. They're not going to roll over. They're going to go out there, give it their all, and try to win these next 2 games. And let's face it, guys, these next 2 games are very, very winnable. However, first thing that we need, guys, look, I know we need to take care of business against the boys, which I truly believe that we will, but we also need some help, okay? We need some help. And the Carolina Panthers and Matt Rhule are facing off against the Washington football team around the same time we will be facing off against Dallas. It's a 4:05 kickoff. Carolina will be in Washington, and that game is going to determine whether or not we have an opportunity to play in the playoffs. So to Matt Rhule and to the Carolina Panthers, please give us a gift. Matt, you know that we still love you here in Philly. So bring Philadelphia a Christmas gift because we know Carolina, this is just the first year. This is the start off year. You guys are going to be good. But let Philly have a couple more laughs, a couple more hurrahs here before you guys start turning it up. But no. So we really need Carolina to beat Washington, and then comes our game. So 4:25, I believe. It's a around 4 o'clock game. Dallas and Philly. Now, if you remember the first time we played Dallas, it was early on the season, right before the bye week. So week 7, we played Dallas, and it was the Ben DiNucci game. Ben DiNucci and the Dallas Cowboys came up to Philly, and we all remember what Carson Wentz was this whole entire year, and that was another bad game. Even though we won, Carson had four turnovers, 2 fumbles and 2 interceptions in that game, and we were so lucky. I know it was like a 23-7 game, but we had no business winning by that margin because a Dallas Cowboys team who was pretty bad at that time, Ben DiNucci was a bad quarterback, clearly, they still were in this game. They were in that game. They certainly were in that game. And I really think that the inefficiency of the offense, the turnovers, really was a difference in that game. But now you fast forward to now, we all know what's going on with the Eagles. Jalen Hurts has given a new spark to the Philadelphia Eagles. This offense looks different. It's not explosive. Let's face it. But the ball is being moved. And the most important part, what we have seen over the past couple weeks, is a couple things. But the most important thing to me is the no turnovers. The no turnovers have been the big thing. That's the reason why we've had better opportunity winning these games. We almost beat the Arizona Cardinals last week. And it is what it is. Kyler Murray was special. And the offensive line couldn't hold up and couldn't keep Jalen Hurts clean as much as possible. And we all know what happened at the end of that game. But so the question is here, how do we beat the Cowboys? But this is a very, very, very winnable game. And I think that the Eagles, if you look at the lines, are favored to win this game. But we have seen the Eagles play down to opponents at times, and this is an NFC East battle. I know that both these teams are bad, but when you're talking about the NFC East and in a matchup like this, especially Dallas and Philly, when there's so much hate going from both sides, like, records get thrown out the window. You show up, you gotta play, you gotta give it your full effort, and whatever happens, happens. But I really like our chances. So when we're looking at this Eagles offense going up against this Dallas defense, this Dallas defense has been able to get turnovers, and especially last week that they did a good job of, you know, getting turnovers against that Niners offense. The Niners offense is bad when Nick Mullins is in there. He does not know how to not turn the ball over. So it's very, very, very important that we do not give Dallas any free gives, okay? I know it's Christmas, I know it's a season of giving, but we're not giving the ball away. Don't give the ball away. And the good thing is that Jalen has done a good job of not giving the ball away. He has had a couple of fumbles that needs to be fixed in these two games. That has been a problem, but you're talking about, you know, no interceptions in these two games that he started. He hasn't taken as many sacks. This offensive line is not good at all, ladies and gentlemen. It's not good at all. The sacks are going to happen. I think Jalen had 6 sacks get to him last week, which is not good either. But if we can maintain no turnovers, then I like it. The other key is, I feel like every week when we talk about the keys for the Eagles, running the damn ball. And you really have to run the ball here. When the Niners did a good job with Matt Breida running the ball. And running the ball, just for us, like, we know what that creates, especially when you're talking about a young quarterback like Jalen Hurts running the ball with Miles Sanders and creating that play action. You know Jalen Hurts is going to get his running the ball as well, getting outside the pocket or design run plays as well. But that running game, again, I know we talk about it every single week, but that is going to be a key here. And it's so frustrating because I feel like the game plan should be simple to beat the Dallas Cowboys. Like, you run the ball, you set up the play action, you beat them like that. You do hurry up, the quick hurry up plays. Like, this Dallas defense is not as sharp as you would expect. And they have a pass rush with that running game. You guys know that helps neutralize a pass rush. But again, I just don't trust this Eagles offensive coaching staff and mostly Doug Peterson with this game here. You know, you even saw last week against Arizona. How many first and tens did we see Doug Peterson throwing the ball? Like, why are we throwing the ball on every single first and 10? So the game plan seems simple, but we have to execute it. And we haven't really done that to perfection this whole entire year. So I want Boston Scott to be implemented more. I think he had 2 carries last week. That's not enough. He is if you give him enough opportunities, he will explode for one. I mean, I'm not even going to get into Jordan Howard because that is just a big question mark in its own. Why is he not even on the field at all now? So that since in these 2 starts, we haven't even seen Jordan Howard, which is a head scratcher. I think that Jalen Reagor can be used in a certain skill set this week. I think if you watched the Niners and Cowboys game, I really like the way that the Niners used Brandon Ayuk. Doing those jet sweeps, those reverses, the fake reverses and whatnot. I think that's something that you can do with Jalen Reagor. If you could just spread out this Dallas defense, it's going to leave that wide open, that middle of the field wide open for you to run, to pass. I expect Dallas Goedert and Zach Ertz to have big games here against the boys. The tight ends is something that the Dallas Cowboys are not good at defending whatsoever. So, again, the game plan seems simple, but you got to go out there and execute. And we've seen Alshon Jeffrey play well the past 2 weeks with Jalen Hurts. You know he's going to play well when Carson Wentz isn't starting. So if Alshon Jeffrey can give you his, that's another weapon that Dallas really can't stop. So that would definitely help the passing attack as well. Nyheim Diggs for the Dallas Cowboys. We saw him when he was here in Philly. He is a turnover machine, and he's going to be a good cornerback in this league. So whoever he's on, test him. I would definitely test him. Jalen is clearly not scared as well, and Jalen does know him from his Alabama days. So definitely test him. Now, when it comes to the Dallas Cowboys offense versus our defense here, So Dallas has had a resurgence with their running game. Zeke should start. He's been hurt the past couple weeks, but the expectations from what I'm hearing is he will play this week against the Eagles. But they have a new running back in Tony Pollard, who's created sort of a spark for their offense, and he could do a little bit more than what Zeke can do. He can run in between the tackles. He can run outside. He can even catch a damn ball. He runs hard. He's a workhorse, and kind of worried about him because we do a good job stopping the run. That is something that we do a good job at. We did a solid job at stopping the Arizona Cardinals running attack last week, but the problem is that the passing attack has not been good for the Philadelphia Eagles. And you even saw a guy like Chase Edmonds was able to attack the Eagles off defense by catching the ball from the backfield. And I think that Pollard can do the same things against us. Now, if Zeke is in there, I like that, because that takes away from Pollard's carries. And I feel like when you pay any player the money that Zeke is making, you gotta try to put him out there. That's the same thing we talk about with Carson Wentz, like the fact that we need him to start because of the money that he is making. But I think Dallas is in a similar situation. You got to go with the hot hand. I think you got to start Pollard, but you know, I hope they start Zeke and take Pollard's carries away. We know that Andy Dalton is the starting quarterback for the Dallas Cowboys. We didn't get to see him earlier in this year in Week 7, but it's the same old Andy Dalton that we've seen in Cincinnati. He gives you enough plays, but he won't make the enough plays to get you the win, right? We know that they have some dangerous wide receivers. You know, CeeDee Lamb, someone we probably should have traded up to draft. They still got Amari Cooper. Michael Gallup has been solid as well. And then they have this new guy, Brown, and from the slot that I'm hearing from Dallas. I forget his first name. But so they have weapons. And that's the thing that worries me is the passing attack, because we are not good at defending good passing attacks. So, again, on something, I feel like every week we talk about running the ball and the defensive line getting after it. Well, the defensive line, again, is going to have to get after it, rattle Andy Dalton, and that shouldn't be too hard. Stop the run, and then just the secondary needs to contain. It needs to contain it. I think we will get Darius Slay back this week. He should be good from the concussion protocol. We saw Michael Jacquet give you great effort against one of the best, if not the best, wide receiver right now in the NFL with DeAndre Hopkins. So I feel better with the secondary. Now, look, I really feel comfortable in going into this game because of this Eagles team that I've seen over the last 2 weeks. Jalen Hurts has really put this team on his back. He's created a new energy with this team, and that is really important going into this Dallas game, because Dallas has won back-to-back games against bad teams. We're talking about Cincinnati without Joe Burrow. We're talking about the Niners. The Niners have had their fair share of issues this year, so this is not going to be the same team that Dallas is playing. And I think if Jalen can continue giving you the spark that he has given you over the last 2 weeks, there is no reason why the Philadelphia Eagles should not win this game down in Dallas. I got the Birds winning this game here. I think it should be a 27-17 game. I think this will be the biggest margin of victory for the Eagles. But again, you got to take care of business. You definitely have to take care of business. Fingers crossed. Definitely a little nervous, but I think that what we have seen the past couple years with the Eagles is no fluke. Doug knows how to get these guys up. It's this time right now, the perfect timing. And I think that they're gonna show up big these next 2 weeks. Against Dallas, against Washington, division games, Doug is going to get these guys up. I think we should win out. But Matt Rhule, Carolina, do us a favor, please, 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 please. All right, guys, in the comments below, let's continue the conversation going. Let me know what you're feeling against the Dallas Cowboys. Do you want to win? I guess it's a fair question to ask now. Do you want to win, or are you someone in the running that we should probably tank for the pick? Let me know in the comments below. Let's continue the conversation. Thank you so much for watching. If you watched up to this point, but please do not forget to hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, hit that bell button for notifications, as well as sharing this video and this channel to help your favorite Parcero grow here in Philadelphia. Ladies and gentlemen, I go by the name of El Parcero Philly, and I am telling you guys, go Birds! Talk to you soon.